Peeper?
Hi! Welcome to Cooking with Real Vegans.
Hello. Tonight we're going to be making Lithuanian Borscht, which is a summer soup called, not like what most people are used to. And it uses beets, cucumbers, potatoes, dill, white wine vinegar, salt and pepper, potatoes. Did I say that? Anyway, it's a pretty involved process because there are a lot of steps, but it's so worth it. Oh, there's sour cream in there too. And I use the tofu-y sour cream to make it totally vegan. And so what we're going to do first is clean up the beets and get them boiled, and then we have to julienne them and chop them and grate them and blah, blah, blah. It's a delicious soup. You can eat it at any time of the day. You can eat it for breakfast. It's also good for dinner when you saute some onions and put them right on top of there. So it's nice hot onions on top of a cold soup. Delicious. So I hope you enjoy it, and we'll go through how we're gonna proceed in a second. I've gotten most of the preparation done already. Okay, here are the beets that have been boiled and peeled. Once you boil them and let them cool, you can peel them very easily. These are grated beets. It's about a quarter of the amount I'm going to be using. The rest of the beets are going to be julienned. We're using 3 pounds of beets, so 3/4 of that amount are going to be julienned with this wonderful little device that I acquired, which just does this. Look at this. Watch that. Boom. Look at that. Is that not the most beautiful thing? Look at that. So you got your julienne beets, and you can do the same thing with the cucumbers that are going to go in there. Okay, they're all going into the pot. Okay, so we're going to be using 2 cups of cucumbers, and we're going to julienne them. And you put those right in there. Throw that up a little bit. There you go. Done for now. Hey, listen, I left the filament because it's Brooklyn, all right? So I don't want to hear it. All right, now that we've prepared most of the basic stuff to make this soup, but I'm going to do the last part right now because we want to speed it up a bit so we can get it done and show you the whole finished product in a timely manner. So what I've done is I've taken a cup of the liquid out of the soup that's already been cooked. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to put it in this blender here. And I'm going to add this unbelievably good tofu-y sour cream. Got to add a pint of that to this mixture. And see, a pint is how much? How much is a pint?
3 dithers.
Let's see, a cup is 8 ounces. So a pint is 2 cups?
I think it's 1.5 Heather gills.
Does anybody know how much a pint is?
No, I forget.
A pint. Pint's down and rolled around.
Yeah, that's nice, Oliver, but, you know, I need to know, I need to know.
And Ed are being very helpful.
Okay, anyway, what I'm going to do is forget about how much a pint is. I just know how much I add, which is 2 containers of these things. Actually, it's going to be 1.5. Now, I'm going to blend that up nicely. All right, I'd say that's about 8 seconds, maybe 10 seconds. Here, okay, 10 seconds in the blender. All right, so there you go, and you got that nice frothy mix in there. You're gonna mix it right into the soup. Slowly. Look at that, look at that. Come on, get that color. Whoa, yeah. That's what I'm talking about. Look at that. Oh, this is gonna be so good. Everybody loves this soup, including the chickens and the cats. Okay, that's done. And now I'm gonna fry up some onions.
I
forgot one of the most important ingredients, the potatoes. I boiled up some potatoes, I cut them up. Not everybody adds potatoes to this, but I think it adds a nice sort of hearty bulk to it. I know, that's about 3 potatoes. I cut them up, put them in there, mix them up good. That's it. And so what you do with this, you're going to let that soup cool, get it nice and chilled, and then you're going to take your onions and you're just going to sprinkle them on top, chop some of this bread up, Dip it in there, heat it up. We're finally done making the soup. I'm gonna put some in a bowl so you can see how beautiful all those delicious things are. So we're gonna take some of these onions here. Just gonna sprinkle that on there like that. There is your beautiful Lithuanian borscht, ice cold. That's good. Gotta put a little more pepper on there. Can never have enough pepper or garlic. Get another enough garlic in here. Put a little more pepper on there. And now we're gonna cut some of Ed's bread to put into this delicious, delicious soup. Oh yeah. Never have enough pepper. Huh?
One of the ingredients in the original recipe for tonight's episode of Borscht was chicken broth. We, of course, used vegetable broth, but what I'd like to do is pretend that we actually use chicken broth. And I'd like to just talk about the history behind that can of chicken broth. So let's imagine us going into the supermarket and buying a can of Swanson's chicken broth. And then let's kind of take it back in time and go to the very beginning of that can. In the beginning of that can is a chicken house, let's say in Maryland, with 20,000 chickens in it. All of the chickens are under 6 weeks of age because that's when they're sent to slaughter. And most of them are alive, fighting for food and water. Some of them are dead because those are the ones who weren't able to reach the food and water, which progressively gets higher. The whole place stinks of ammonia. So lots of the chickens are blind because they've been blinded by the ammonia. At about 6 weeks, the slaughter trucks come and the chickens are thrown into the cages. They're taken to the slaughterhouse where they're hung by their legs, rolled on conveyor belts past whirling knives that are supposed to cut their heads off, which they do sometimes and sometimes they don't, so the chickens are then conscious when they're dismembered. Then their bodies are processed, and some of their bodies end up in cans of chicken broth. Now, I've had this soup made with chicken broth, and I've had it made with vegetable broth. And I can tell you there really isn't much of a difference. So, what I ask is that if you're not vegan, the next time you go to make a recipe that contains animal ingredients, I want you to think about what's behind that ingredient. And the pain and suffering that went into that one little taste. And I want you to think about whether or not it's worth it to have all that pain and suffering for a second of enjoyment, especially when you can find enjoyment in so many other ways. So, please think about that. Have a great night. And when you dream, think about going to the vegetable broth instead.
Oh, yeah.
For more information, please visit our website at vine.bravebirds.org. That's V as in vegan, I-N-E, .bravebirds.org. Or you can email us, sanctuary@bravebirds.org. Thanks for watching.